Solar panels and parking bays, an unlikely combination to get people's blood boiling. But a day after the budget was handed down, the small print has angered thousands of people across the state. Daniel Donnelly reports.
More than 70,000 West Australian households took up the investment in green energy, with a promise from Synergy to pay households 40 cents for every unit of solar electricity pumped back into the grid. The contract was meant to last 10 years.
Are you tearing that contract up?
Yes.
The budget saver will halve the solar rebate to 20 cents by July next year.
How do I ever believe anything that my government tells me again?
It's devastating news for Gillian Argentino, who borrowed $18,500 to pay for solar panels.
You've got to stand by your word. You can't just walk away when it suits.
Gillian will now seek legal advice over the broken contract.
Well, the advice we've had is that what we're doing is allowable within the constraints of the contracts.
More than $5.5 billion was allocated to public transport infrastructure in yesterday's budget. But it comes at a cost. Free parking at train stations across Perth will be scrapped from next year, including at a new 1,000-bay multi-storey car park in Edgewater.
I don't see it as being an issue, asking people to pay $2 to park in a parking bay. A quarter of people already do.
There are fears charging for parking at train stations could force motorists to park in surrounding streets. But Troy Buswell says that won't happen, and car parks will still be full after fees are introduced in July next year. The opposition says the fees will slug regular train users an extra $460 a year, on top of the cost of living increase for the average household of $235 a year.
This will reduce the incentive to catch the train. It will increase the pressure on surrounding streets with parking, and commuters have every right to be unhappy.
Daniel Donnelly, 10 News.